Over recent months, Ireland's streets have become a front line for protesters as the country prepares to vote in a historic referendum that could change its constitution.
5, 6, 7, 8!
Time to repeal the 8!
What do we want?
Repeal the 8!
When do we want it?
Now!
These thousands of protesters want to repeal a provision known as the 8th Amendment, which grants an equal right to life to both mother and the unborn and makes abortion a crime in Ireland.
For 35 years, people in Ireland have lived under the shadow of the 8th Amendment, but we are the people who will enact change.
Get your rosary!
Rita Harold is a reproductive rights advocate.
We're marching for repeal today because the Irish Constitution blocks almost all types of abortions. So that includes health-saving abortions, it includes abortions for rape survivors, but it also includes the majority of abortions where people are pregnant and do not wish to be. This has to change. We need the right to determine the course of our own futures.
Backed by this constitutional guarantee, Ireland's abortion laws are among the most restrictive in the world.
We have a 14-year prison sentence for women who obtain abortions illegally in this country. We have an absolute abortion ban unless you are dying as a result of your pregnancy.
Sorka Tunney leads Amnesty International's campaign for repeal.
We want to make sure that in situations where you have a crisis pregnancy, if it's resulting from rape, if your health is at risk, that you will be looked after in this country, that your doctors will be able to care for you in this country, and that we will legislate for you in this country.
Abortion has been outlawed here since Ireland's independence in 1922, but the ban was later enshrined in the Constitution through the 8th Amendment when conservatives in the country sensed a global trend.
We had a very strong Catholic Church, we had a very strong religious ethos in the country, and in the 80s, Ireland was seen to be responding to what was happening globally when it comes to women's rights, and particularly when it comes to women's human rights and abortion. Obviously, Roe v. Wade had happened previously in the US, and entities within the Irish state decided that it was time that there was needed to be a constitutional protection because they felt that at some point there would be a liberal abortion or liberalised abortion regime in this country.
There have been previous attempts to loosen Ireland's abortion laws, but it was the death of 31-year-old Savita Halappanavar in 2012 that activists credit as a turning point. She died as a result of a septic miscarriage after her pleas for an abortion were refused. A successful referendum to legalize same-sex marriage in 2015 also galvanized progressives.
We are at a turning point in history. But the fact is that history is only catching up with the way society has been progressing for years, in fact, for decades.
This evening, the Cabinet gave formal approval to the holding of a referendum on abortion.
In January, the Irish government announced it would hold a nationwide vote to determine the fate of the 8th Amendment.
Save the babies!
Save the 8th!
We will not discriminate!
Fierce battle lines have been drawn. Indeed, just days after the rally to repeal the 8th, these very same Dublin streets were filled with chants of tens of thousands of people calling to save it. While specific numbers are hard to know, Ireland's rate of abortion is understood to be low relative to neighboring England, where about 1 in 6 pregnancies end in abortion. Ireland has an estimated rate of about 1 in 13.
There is no other law in Ireland where we can point to and say it has saved that many lives. So for that reason, we really need to keep it.
Anti-abortion activist Cora Sherlock fears losing the 8th Amendment would put Ireland on a dangerous path.
If you look at Ireland and compare Ireland to the rest of the world, in Ireland, every human being is protected under our law at present with the 8th Amendment. Without the 8th Amendment, we'd turn into a very different country. We would become a country where abortion on demand would happen over a very short period of time. That's what the government is putting on the table.
We all know somebody in our lives who is here today because of the 8th Amendment. For me, it's the person I grew up with, and for other people, it could be a son, a daughter, it could be a niece.
21-year-old Katie Asco has become a prominent face of the Save the 8th movement. She was recently impeached as student union president at her university after her anti-abortion views became part of a campus-wide debate. Since then, she's taken her fight for the cause national.
So often, abortion doesn't really feel like a choice for a woman. Abortion, it often feels like it's either an abortion or your job. It's either an abortion or your college degree. It's either an abortion or your future. That is not a true choice for women. We need to be rallying around our women, supporting them and encouraging them and giving them the means and the materials that they need. But we need to be looking at positive alternatives to abortion.
In defiance of the current laws, a growing number of Irish women illegally obtain abortion pills online to terminate their pregnancies. Another 3,000 to 4,000 women travel abroad for abortions every year, most often to England.
So we have a situation where we either export our women to access abortion in another country or we import illegal drugs to access abortion here. Women feel like criminals. They wouldn't turn up for post-abortion care in this country because they were fearful that they would be reported.
The reality of thousands of Irish women travelling abroad for abortions is a main rallying cry for pro-repeal supporters, like this group that carried rolling suitcases in protest.
I travelled for an abortion 6.5 years ago myself, and so I know the stress that it puts people under.
This woman, who asked not to be identified, travelled to England to end an unplanned pregnancy.
So flew over, Mum was with me, and got to the clinic, and they're lovely, they're so lovely, and I could immediately tell the other Irish women in the room with their day bags, and most of them were by themselves. Women who don't have the money to travel and can't travel, they do horrific things to themselves to try and end a pregnancy, and I call myself one of the lucky ones, because I can't even imagine how trapped they must feel.
The majority of Ireland's political leaders have come out in favour of repealing the Eighth Amendment, including the Prime Minister and even some Conservative leaders.
I believe that we should remove the Eighth Amendment from Bun Rock.
The Catholic Church is strongly against repeal, making this referendum a vote not just on abortion, but on the continued power of the Church in this overwhelmingly Catholic country.
This has been seen as, where some people are concerned, as the last great battleground were controlled by the Catholic Church in Ireland.
Patsy McGarry has been the religion news correspondent for the Irish Times for 2 decades.
The trend where the Church is concerned is downwards. Where its influence is concerned is downwards in terms of just influence, number one, but also in terms of the numbers of its own personnel. Priests are dying out, nuns are dying out. It's an ageing institution. So it's facing a massive crisis in Ireland, and it's not doing a lot about it.
Parishioners attending Sunday morning mass were split.
Well, they have a right to life in God's eyes. You know, they're born, they're human beings from the moment of conception. So they have a right to life. Who am I, or who is anybody else, to take away that right?
Yeah, I think it's up to the individual what they want to do, and they should be given the choice.
Even if the Eighth Amendment is repealed, abortion would not be immediately accessible in Ireland. New legislation would still have to be passed. Many lawmakers have backed a bill permitting abortion up to 12 weeks.
Hey, hey, ho, ho! The Eighth Amendment has to go! Hey,
the latest polls suggest a majority of Irish voters will support a repeal of the Eighth Amendment and its constitutional ban on abortion. Regardless of the outcome, Friday will be a decisive moment in Irish history.